Hi, today we meet again in Biology Drew Revision Session, broadcast on YouTube. I am Teacher Yumni. Today, I would like to do a revision with my students at home for the Chapter 5. Okay, so today, our teacher will discuss three essays, which are two short essays and one full marks, 15 marks long essay. Okay, we start with the first essay. The question, explain the structure of ATP and their main functions. As usual, you need to see the marks provided. It is 6 marks. So you need to explain structure and main functions. So straightforward, go to the object of the question. Adenosine triphosphate, ATP, is a relatively small soluble organic molecule. Adenosine consists of purine, base, adenine, and the pentose sugar ribose. So purine, base, adenine, and the pentose sugar ribose. So adenosine is bonded to 3 phosphate groups and known as adenosine triphosphate. So for this explanation, okay, you will obtain 1 mark for structure. Adenosine consists of purine base, adenine, and the pentose sugar ribose. And adenosines bonded to 3 phosphate groups. So that's why their name known as adenosine triphosphate. So another 1 mark. Sorry, 1 mark. So this is for your information. This is the structure of ATP as mentioned. You got adenine group, pentose sugar ribose. Sorry, so we said adenosine and ribose sugar together with 3 phosphate group. And then we continue. ATP is a perfect energy resource for all living cells. The energy from ATP used for nearly all activities of living organisms, such as transport work, active transport, moving substances across membrane, as we already know in previous lesson, mechanical work, supplying the energy needed for muscle contraction. Okay, so for this function, you obtain 1 mark and mechanical work 1 mark. So we continue with functions of ATP for chemical work. ATP supplying the energy to synthesize macromolecules that is needed by cells such as protein, lipid, cholesterol, cellulose. Another function, next function, impulse transmission in cells, growth. Mentioned another function, growth and division of cells. And last, changes the shape of gut cells, which regulation of the stomach opening due to ATP provided. So for these statements, so you will obtain 1 marks for each statement. All right, so together with the structure of ATP, you will obtain 6 full marks. Okay, and then we continue. Okay, today, before we continue with other essay question, this is additional infos about ATP that you should know. Okay, for usually in objective questions, they will ask ATP use for in animals. So it is for an active transport, muscle contraction, synthesize micromolecule, impulse transmission, growth, and cell division. In plants, ATP also for active transport, growth, and cell division. Okay, then you should know that the negative aspect of ATP is that it cannot be stored for a long period of time because it is too reactive and releases the PI too easily. That's why in plants, the Calvin cycle occurs and when the ATP is available. Okay, then so now, as you know that ATP, it is too reactive and releases the PI2 easily. So it releases PI via hydrolysis of ATP. So as you know that phosphates are high energy molecules, so therefore a lot of energy is released when the phosphate groups are removed. A vast amount of energy from ATP actually is given out when the bond between the second and the third phosphate molecules and the bond between the first and the second phosphate molecules are broken down. So when the second and third phosphate molecules broken down, so it becomes two phosphate groups. Okay, they release one PI, so it becomes diphosphate. And then when the first and second phosphate molecules are broken down, it is GTP. Okay, previously second and third phosphate molecules, ADP. First and second phosphate molecules are broken down, GTP. So ATP has high free energy of hydrolysis. So hydrolysis of one molecule of ATP will yield 30.6 kilojoules of energy. So the phosphorylation of one mole of ATP consumes the same amount of energy. Okay, here how the releases PI will become ADP and GTP. Okay, so the here is the graphic for that explanation. The hydrolysis of ATP in the biological process is as follows. ATP plus water to broken down one phosphate group. So it will become ADP. So adenosine ribose triphosphate will become ADP. All right. So actually the role of ATP, if you can see from the slides previously, it is for transport and store energy as an instant energy source for most biochemical reactions and activities of organism. Okay, now teacher would like to elaborate more about ATP yield in respiration. Okay, because this part nowadays quite tricky. Okay, so from the glycolysis, okay, it will produce 2 ATP and 2 NAD plus, right? Reduce NAD plus will become NADH. Okay, then from link reaction, it will produce 2 NAD plus and reduce to become NADH. So from here, 2 reduced NAD later will become 5 ATP. Also, and FAD become 3 ATP. You know why? Because teacher, from this diagram, because 1 NADH equal to 2.5 ATP and 1 FADH equal to 1.5 ATP. So you will total, you will get, you will get 32 ATP. Okay, you can use this calculation. Or you can use this calculation, 1 NADH equal 3 ATP or 1 FADH equal 2 ATP. So if you use this equation, you will get total 36 ATP. Okay, so here is the thing. For your syllabus, it is still 1 NADH. And 1 NADH equal to 3 ATP and 1 FADH equal to 2 ATP. While actually in the latest international reference books, it mentions this calculation. So which one you want to use in the examination? You can use somehow this or this, but my recommendation, please use this one because it is still in the previous syllabus, nothing updates about and no update yet about this equation, okay? But you should know, because if you read the latest international books, it will mention 32 ATP, okay? So here, and one more thing. Okay, for NAD plus, all right, so NAD plus here accepts a hydrogen ion and two electrons. So as it becomes reduced to NADH plus H plus, so the NADH moves to the ETC and donates a pair of electrons. So we said it becomes oxidized to the first compound in the chain. So I hope that you know more confusion about NAD plus reduced to NADH plus H plus more, okay? So now we continue with the second essay. Describe process formation of ATP via oxidative phosphorylation. It is a 5 marks. So first, you need to explain the object. Oxidative phosphorylation is the process of ATP formation through the oxidation of hydrogen atoms that are brought by hydrogen carriers. Oxygen will combine with hydrogen atoms to form water at the end. Okay, the splitting of the hydrogen atoms into protons and electrons occurs in the matrix. Protons will enter the intermembrane space of the mitochondrion, whereas the electrons will flow along the inner membrane. And the last one is the hydrogen atoms are initially passed along the chain by hydrogen carriers, but they will split into protons and electrons to be passed along by the electron carriers in the electron transport chain. Okay, so this is about formation of ATP via oxidative phosphorylation. So each statement, you will obtain 1 mark. So total 5 marks. Okay. Okay, then another. Okay, the last essay question. Last essay question, but you still got 2 structure questions. Okay, we continue with this first. Okay, explain the final stage in cellular respiration. What is that? It is the electron transport chain and the synthesis of ATP by chemiosmosis. Again, about ATP. So first things that you need to know, that first stage in electron transport chain is a complex 1, NADH ubiquinone oxidoreductase accepts electrons from NADH molecules. As we know that ETC is the about electrons transfer. All right, so electrons transfer to create the chemical gradient, then to produce ATP. Okay, so complex one. Okay, this is the stage in the electron transport chain, and the explanation, when you explain, at least your explanation consists all this. Okay, NADH supplies electrons to the first electron carrier in the chain complex 1, redox reaction occurs where NADH is oxidized and complex 1 is reduced. So when one substance oxidizes and another substance is reduced, we say a redox reaction. Then hydrogen ions are pumped to intermembrane space or outer compartment. So for this, you will obtain 1 mark and the explanation of 1 mark. So for the first stage, total you will obtain 2 marks. Then stage 2, context 2, succinate ubiquinone oxidoreductase accepts electrons from FADH2 molecules. So explanation for this stage, FADH2 supplies electrons to the first electron carrier in the chain complex 2, which succinate ubiquinone oxidoreductase. Okay, so because this question is 15 marks, you need to mention this complex and a complex name and enzymes. So it at complex 2, enzyme succinate ubiquinone oxidoreductase. Then redox reaction occurs where FADH2 is oxidized and at the same time, complex 2 is reduced, right? So for this stage, you will obtain 1 mark from this main statement, and anything in statements in this explanation, you will obtain another mark. So it is 1 mark and 1 mark, 2 marks at the stage 2, so total 4 marks now. Then we continue with stage 3. Ubiquinone Q accepts electrons from complex 1 and 2. So at the ubiquinone Q, all right, what happened? Complex 1 and 2 will pass electrons to ubiquinone Q. Redox reaction happen where complex 1 and 2 are oxidized and ubiquinone Q is reduced. But there is no hydrogen transfer or pump in. All right, so complex 3, ubiquinone, cytochrome C, oxidoreductase accepts electrons from ubiquinone Q. So complex 3 will receive electrons from ubiquinone Q. Then redox reaction happen where ubiquinone Q is oxidized and complex 3 is reduced. Hydrogen is pumped to intermembrane space or outer compartment. So if you notice at the stage 3, ubiquinone Q just pass the electrons, redox reaction happens, but no hydrogen is pumped to intermembrane space. So for this explanation, so you obtain 1 mark for each statement. And then we continue. Cytochrome C accepts electrons from complex 3 and pass to complex 4. The explanation for this stage, cytochrome C will pass electrons to complex 4, where does the redox reaction occur? Cytochrome C is oxidized and complex 4 is reduced. And stage 6, complex 4 accept electrons from cytochrome C. Electrons are transferred to oxygen and water is formed. So explanation for stage 6, electrons to transfer to complex 4 to reduce oxygen, and oxygen is a final electron acceptor in the electron transport complex. So for each statement related, you will obtain 1 mark. So you already got 12 marks. Okay, so stick six stages. So 6 times 2 is already 12. Another 3 marks because the question asks about chemiosmosis. So it is about energy coupling mechanism. So at complex 1, 3, and 4, hydrogen ions are pumped to the intermembrane space, thus creating an electrochemical gradient where high hydrogen concentration outside the matrix. Okay, then you continue with the hydrogen ions flow back into the matrix through the protein channel, which is associated with the ATP synthase enzyme. This provides energy to synthesize ATP from ADP and inorganic phosphate. So for this explanation, you will obtain 1 mark when you mention about how electrochemical gradient hydrogen concentration outside the matrix is created. Then the hydrogen ions flow back into the matrix through a protein channel which is associated with the ATP synthase enzymes. So you mentioned about hydrogen ions flow back into the matrix, and then this provides energy to synthesize ATP from ADP and inorganic phosphate. All right. So total 3 marks at here at the chemiosmosis explanation. So total, when you calculate all the right tick in this slide for this question, you will obtain 15 marks. Okay, another tips. If you realize complex 2, all right, does not involve the pumping of hydrogen. Okay, it's not, complex 2 does not involve the pumping of hydrogen's ions from the matrix, okay, into the intermembrane space. All right, here, if you're not sure the structure, because complex 2 is just half embedded in the plasm membrane of the mitochondrion. Ubiquinone Q is formed by lipid, and it is only electron carrier, which is not a protein. Okay? Okay, I already explained everything. For 3 essay questions, and then now I would like you to answer past year question number 17 STPM 2016 and number 17 STPM 2018. All right, so answer this question in your past year module book. Okay, all right. Okay, that's all for this session. We will see again in the next session. All right, that's all for today. Okay, that's all. Bye.